Cord cutting was supposed to usher in a new age of cheap a la carte TV, right? Well, it looks like our dreams of a la carte TV are long gone. Long live the bundle, I suppose. But cheap TV, at least, is still within reach. Of course, if you want it, you'll have to skip past the big brand names like Hulu Live, YouTube TV, and AT&T, and take a hard look at the little streaming service that could, Philo TV. It ain't for everybody, that's for sure, but it might be the service that convinces you to keep many of basic cable's best channels in your life. But there's only one way to find out, so let's dive in. All right, thanks for watching, everybody. If you haven't yet, then make sure to subscribe and hit that bell so you know when we have more videos much like this one. And if this video turns out to be helpful, give it a like, it would be much appreciated. Okay, now Philo, it's not new. It's been around for several years now, but it is starting to pick up a little bit more buzz nowadays, and I'm hearing a lot more about it in the comments from you folks. And the reason why should become apparent as we get into the details. So let's start at the obvious place, price. Because if Philo is attractive for one reason, it's the price. 20 bucks a month, that's it. No premium tier, no extra cost for DVR, and only a couple of perfectly ignorable premium add-ons. It's super simple and super cheap, and so for some people, it's gonna be super attractive, especially standing next to the likes of Hulu Live, YouTube TV, and AT&T TV Now. Whew. There are two major questions to address then. First, what can you get for 20 bucks a month? And second, what are you sacrificing compared to its more expensive competition? For that price, there's gotta be a catch, right? Well, yes and no. Let's dig a little deeper, starting with the channels you get on Philo. For 20 bucks, you get 61 channels. Not a bad price per channel. Honestly, to get that many channels on AT&T TV Now, for instance, you have to bump up to their $80 a month package. Whew. Sling TV promises 30 channels for 30 bucks. And the cost per channel story isn't much better on Hulu Live or YouTube TV. So what gives? Why is Philo that much cheaper? Well, let's take a closer look at their channel offering. It's not like they don't have any big name stuff. We've got MTV, HGTV, AMC, Nickelodeon, Food Network, Discovery, and on and on. Lots of great stuff in there. I think it's fair to say that yes, there is some padding in there too. I've never heard of Revolt or Access TV or Clio, and I'm not likely to be interested in INSP since I'm an INTP, but hey, that's okay. Honestly, I think we can excuse a little filler in the channel count since every TV bundle since the advent of cable has had them. No, more interesting is what we're missing. We're missing whole categories of channels here. There's no sports, no news, and no local channels. And that lack has radiating consequences. Channels aren't standalone affairs. They're owned by networks that have a lot of channels to sell. And that's why whenever you see MTV on a service, you're also gonna see BET, VH1, CMT, and Nickelodeon because they're all owned by Viacom, which sells them as a package. So Philo doesn't have the Disney Channel because if they want to get the Disney Channel, then they also have to sign on for ESPN and every other channel that Disney owns. And if they did that, it would instantly double Philo's monthly cost. And then sports fans who got ESPN would want Fox Sports to go alongside it, and regional networks, and college networks. And it's not just sports either, ditto over on the cable news side of things. And now you can see why YouTube TV raised its price to 65 bucks a month. It seems ludicrous, right up until you really dig into the cost of bringing you all those channels. Now, some people would point to the channel lineups of all those services and say, see, you get what you pay for. And they're not wrong. But some people point to Philo's lineup and say, see, I'm getting everything I need for a third the cost. I'll stick with them. And they're not wrong either. If you're in it for sports or news, then Philo makes no sense. But if you want some classic cable channels but never watch sports or news, then it really doesn't make much sense not to go with Philo. Honestly, it just depends on what your flavor is. There are a few other things to consider, so let's quickly go over those as well. As I said before, there's no extra cost to the DVR, and the DVR is pretty good, actually. Unlimited recording, just like on YouTube TV, but unlike YouTube TV, where you can keep stuff for 9 months, on Philo, you only get 30 days with those recordings. Still, honestly, not bad. And you can skip the commercials on that DVR, which you can't do on Hulu Live's non-premium priced DVR. So yeah, I'd say Philo's is pretty darn good for no extra cost. As for how to watch it, Philo is supported on almost every major streaming device. You can watch it on the web, or on mobile, on iOS or Android, or you can watch it on Roku, Fire TV, Apple TV, or Android TV. It is missing on game consoles like the PS4 or Xbox, and more importantly, you won't get it on LG, Samsung, or Vizio smart TVs. I hope that will be rectified in the future. We'll see. So with a good DVR and availability on nearly every device, really the question just comes down to whether you're getting the channels you want. Because if you are, $20 a month is gonna be a lot easier pill to swallow than some of the other options out there. So my question to you is, have you used Philo or are you considering it? Let me know your thoughts on Philo in the comments. Thanks for coming along with me on this video. Like I said earlier, if it's helpful to you, I'd appreciate a like on this. Don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you all next time. Thanks for watching.